नमस्ते, वेलकम टू रिलीव वायलिन सेशन 5। आई थॉट ऑफ स्टॉपिंग द सेशंस एट 4, बट आई अगेन थॉट दैट इट इज इम्पोर्टेंट टू गिव यू डिटेल्स अबाउट गमकम्स, हाउ टू अंडरस्टैंड देम सो दैट इट विल बी इजी फॉर यू ऑल टू लर्न and practice various classical and non-classical compositions. So today I'll try to explain those gamakams raga wise. Yes, so we will start in a few minutes. So please let us know if you have any doubts. I hope the audio and the video both are clear. Namaste, Sarmagaru, Dexter, good morning, thank you, good morning. So I can just say good morning, Sunita Garu. Good morning, Saket. AJ, Namaste. This session is very important. Not only this session, even coming 4 or 5 sessions are very important because they deal with the gamakams. So always people talk about gamakams are difficult. What are the gamakams? Some people ask for vibrato and what are the different types of gamakams. All those, a lot of information they ask for. If you can follow the coming 3-4 sessions, whenever I do the live, then I will try to demystify all these gamakams and make you very clear about this gamaka concept. So yeah, I have another session at 8:30. I may be closing it by 8:30 or 8:40 maximum. So I'll try to get into the subject. One is like gamakam. Gamakam is a movement, or an oscillation is a movement, or it travels from one note to another. So when you want to play a gamakam, like if you play Rishabham, Sudarshabham, Amtar Gandharam, Sudhamajjamam, these notes are very straight. There is no movement in between. Sari Gama, Pada, Nisa, Sani, Dapa, Magari. So whatever you play, it is very easy to play plain notes. So in Indian music, in Western music, they use only vibrato. Vibrato is the gamakam. We call it as kampitamu in Indian Carnatic music. Kampitamu. Kampitamu means it will not move from the note, from one note to another like this. It will only move at that note only. So if you are playing ga, if you just move your finger like this, it will be just a vibrato. So I'll show you. Right.
I'll try to explain your doubts at the end. Okay? See? It's like wherever you are there, and you're just moving your finger. That is called vibrato. That is called vibrato. That is called kampitamu in Indian music. Kampitamu, kampita gamakam. So there are 15 types of gamakams. They're called as panchadasa gamakams, and then reclassified into 10 types. That they are dasaveda gamakams, kampitamu, lienamu, tirupamu, tribhirnamu, mudritamu, namitamu. A lot of gamakams are spiritamu. A lot of gamakams, their names are there. But if I teach you, I have a clear document on all these gamakams explaining technically. But if I teach you that, it will be confusing for you all at this stage. So that's why I wanted to introduce you all to the actual gamakams or actual movements amongst the notes that are very much relevant to for you all to apply and learn. So those things I have researched, and whatever I could learn and I could find out, that I am sharing with you all. So one gamakam you are all talking about is a vibrato. Vibrato I have explained you that just a moment. Vibrato, I have explained you all. It is moving at that place. So kampitamu means, what is kampitamu? Is a vibration. Vibration, you know, if you take earthquake, there is an epicenter. It will not, the epicenter will not move from one place to another. It is only one place. It will be like this, and it will make some quakes or kampanas. So it is also like that. So this movement speed can be up to us, like based on the need. So normally in Indian music, Shadjamam, Panchamam, they are all called as Prakriti Swaras. We don't move them. Okay? Then, so Kampitam is over. Anywhere, there is nothing except moving in that place in the required speed. Okay? Now, we will take one after the other, like this time. Today we will try to understand the gamakams. So the gamakams related to Maya Malava Gaula Ragam. So what is gamakam? Gamakam, I told you that the movement. So if any movement, you know that if you want to move, first you need to rule for a movement, either it is a movement in a music or movement in general, requires space. If you have space only, you can move. Okay? If there is no space, you cannot move. Like you see that if you wanted to antar gandharam and suddha madhyamam is there. So if you wanted to move, you cannot move because they are very close. There is no space in between antar gandharamu and Suddha Madhyamam. So if there is no space, then you cannot move, right? So you can just do like this, gama, 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 like that. But if you take so Chatusruti Rishabhamu and Antar Gandharamu, there is a space in between. So you have possibility to move. So if you wanted to move from this place to another place, there should be space to go there. If it is occupied and there is no space, then you cannot go there. I hope you all understand the basic rule of movement or gamakam. For gamakam or movement in Carnatic music or in general needs space to move. So we will try to understand some basic principles, general principles how we can understand these gamakams based on the space. Okay, so yeah, first let us see that maya malava gavala. So are you able to see my fingerboard, right? Hope this is fine. People are asking that to bring here, but it will be very difficult for me to play. If this is okay, then it will be good. Okay, yeah, that is nice. See, now this is Mayamalava Gaularagam, right? So in Mayamalava Gaularagam, we try to understand that where can we get gamakam. Okay, remember shadjamamu panchamamu are natural notes. They are called as prakriti swaras. Okay, prakriti swaras, they don't have any movement generally. Sa 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 pa, they're very plain. Okay, next remaining notes are ri ga ma da ni. Okay, ri ga ma da ni, we'll try to understand the structure of the notes of Mayamalava. Like ri is immediately. Yeah, it can be called as achala swaram also. So achala swarams, it's like, see, they are depends on shadya panchamam or achala swaras, but achala swaras may also, other swaras also can become achala swaras depending on the raga swarupam and raga lakshanam. So natural notes our natural notes, prakriti swaras are only two. Achala swaras means based on the raga lakshanam, ri also can be an achala swaram, or ga also can be achala swaram, but shadjam panchamam also achala swaras. Okay, so now you see this, we have already learned that vishabham is immediately after sa, like, you know, this gut here. So there is no gap in between sa and ri. So if I have to move my ri finger, or if I have to give gamakam, so what are the possibilities of gamakam, we will discuss now. This is ri. And later, after a long gap, like chasutu rishabham, sadharana gandharam, and then after leaving everything, then you are praying here, antar gandharam. So these places are different from the Western music chart. People are asking that, like, can I stick something and play? Because these places are a little bit different, because our Indian music is dependent on just intonation. So in theory, this is just intonation, based on just intonation. They're not equal, like how they spread on the that sheet which you wanted to stick on the violin. You need to listen and mark your places. That is very, very important. So, but in the Western music, they follow an equal temperament formula. So where they get the swaras in equal distance. So though the difference between equal temperament and just intonation is minimal, but there is significant amount of difference in output is there. So that's why we got the 22 swaras, 22 dvavimsati swarasthanas, ekasuti visruti, and each and every swaram, whether this swaram should be a little bit stronger or lighter, all those aspects will come into picture there. So ri is here, and we are going to antar gandharam, and immediately after antar gandharam we have madhyamam. There is no space in between gandharam and madhyamam, right? So ri, we have only space in between ri to ga. This much space is there. There is a lot of space. Otherwise, we don't have any space after ga and ma. After ga, there is ma, there is no space, you see. And after sa, there is re. Re, ga, ma. Like that, only pa, da. Da and ni. And immediately after ni, there is sa. So this is the note structure of Maya Malava Gowda on all strings. Okay? Hope you all got it. But now, which swarams can get gamakam or movement, and what kind of movement that should be, and what is the rule for that? How can we understand that? Okay, now Maya Malava Gowda, if you take. So I cannot move ga. I cannot move ga to ma because immediately ma is there. I cannot move ma. If I move my ma, I may go to pratimadhyam. But the movement should be only between the swarasthanas of that particular ragam. Please keep this in mind. Okay? So, movement should be, or gamakam should be, either in that swarasthanam or from to any other swarasthanam that is there in the ragam. Okay, I cannot move my finger just like this because I may get pratimadhyam which is not there in the ragam. I cannot move my finger to just like this. I may go to chatusruti rishabam or sadharan gandharam. If I have to move, I have to move sa to re or re to ga, re to antar gandharam, sha to sudrishabam or re to antar gandharam or ga to ma and ma to pa or pa to da and ni sa. So, yes, then which swaram, if I started moving all swarams in that ragam, then it won't good. So, gamakam is called as an ornamentation. Ornamentation means alankaram. Alankaram means decoration. So, decoration means you get earring or you get bindi or you get a ring. Okay, you get a watch. You get kurta. So these are all like beautify your personality, right? Then it doesn't mean that you will use that earring here everywhere on the body, will not look good. So it doesn't mean that we should move all the notes. We should understand we should only move. I'm just looking at the chat and I'm getting lost. So we should not move all the swaras. So it won't sound nice. We should identify that as per the ragam, as per the swarasthanas, as per the distance, which note can get the gamakam. So now for Maya Malava Gowda ragam, I am thinking that you try to understand. I will try to demystify it and make it very simple that there are two types of gamakams. One is gamakam means oscillation from one note to another. This is oscillation in the same note, that is called vibrato or kampitam. I am talking about two types of oscillations that are related to one note to another note, or if you wanted to going across the notes, there are two types. One is small oscillation and one is big oscillation. Try to understand small gamakam and big gamakam. So how to understand them, I will explain now. So now shajyamam is a prakriti swaram or achala swaram, or so there is no gamakam, but because it is the base also. So base cannot be shaken. So base should be strong, and on base other swarams we can ornament it. So sa is plain. Next, I wanted to give gamakam to rishabham. So if I wanted to give gamakam to rishabham, the possibilities are like, for any movement, I said that there should be space to move. One, either you have to move here, or if you wanted to go to another place, then there should be space. and based on that space we move. And next thing is that for any movement there should be a previous. If you wanted to move from this place to this place to this place, so that means if you wanted to move, then there is a previous note for that, previous note, and sometimes there may be next note, or what is the higher note and what are the lower note. These are the things very important for giving gamakam. If I have to move, give gamakam to Shuddha Rishabham. Shuddha Rishabham, that is there in Maya Malava Gauda Ragam. Okay, so what is my previous note? The previous note for Shuddha Rishabham is Sada A Shajyamam. So the gamakam can only start in Shajyamam because that is the previous note. Okay, and I have to, because if I wanted to go to Delhi, I have to start from Hyderabad. So if Delhi is my destination, then Hyderabad is my starting point. So I have to start from Hyderabad only. Like that, if I have to give gamakam to Re, the previous note for Re is Sa. Okay, in ascending order, I am telling you Sa. So from Sa to Re, I can move. Okay, Sa to Re, I can move. And another thing is that I can go to another note, the next note, and come back to the actual note. Previous note to next note and come back to the actual note. So see, I'll show you. Try to understand that this is not lifting your finger. I am not lifting. I am moving from this gut point to here. Not with the wrist, just with this thing. A little movement is there, but you all can try to work on this gamakam. Okay. This movement you need to practice. Sari 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 sari. Okay, next there is another possibility is going from Ga to and coming back to Re. That is too much bigger than required. So this movement is not so suitable in oscillative mode for this ragam. Maya Malava Gaulaki pani cheyadu. Ee only just a sliding pani chestundi. Pani chestundi gaani ఇలా ఒక 10 times ఆసిలేట్ చేయడానికి బాగోదు. కానీ ఇఫ్ యూ లుక్ ఎట్ షడ్జమం రిషభం, ఇఫ్ యూ ప్లే ఫర్ 1000 times ఆల్సో ఇట్ సౌండ్స్ నైస్. ఇట్స్ లైక్ ఏ బంబుల్ బీ ఆర్ బీ. దిస్ యూ కెన్ ప్రాక్టీస్ ఇన్ డిఫరెంట్ స్పీడ్ లైక్ దట్. నెక్స్ట్ ఆఫ్టర్ దిస్ నెక్స్ట్ Ga is slide. Ga, Re to Ga. Because the previous note is Ga. The previous note is Re. Re to Ga. Ga, ma. Done, right? Ga, ma. Next, same application for the. Re to the slide. So, many people, what they do is like they don't use the fingers designated for the swaras. They keep this swaram at sa, this finger at sa in first state. They keep this finger at ni. No, this is designated to play the ni finger should be there, and ni to just a slide to the ni finger is there. Ni to just a slide to the. Sa. So this finger should not be in Sa until and unless you go to the second stage. I have already explained that. Okay. So if you go to second stage, only you should be using this finger for Sa. Otherwise, need to the slide and Pa. Remember, 99% of times in a descending order, there is no gamakam. Oscillative gamakam means jaru is also a gamakam. Jaru means slide. There are up slide, yagajaru. Down slide, digajaru. See, yagajaru is up slide. Digajaru, down slide. But we are only discussing not about, we are not discussing about kampitamu because it is clear. And slides. Upside or downslide. Okay, they are very clear. Upside, downslide, and kampitamu are clear. We are only discussing about oscillation that is in between notes. Okay, and what are the possible oscillations for a particular raga? Okay, now. Maga and ga to re-slide. This is Murchana. See, let me play. Sa, di, ga. Ga and re. Slide to re with re finger, but don't keep this finger at ga and keep because ga finger is already there, like that knee also. Sa re ga ma pa ta. Yes. So why there should not be gaaki gamakam oscillative gamakam ledu endukante because ma undi kabatti maake gamakam ivachu ga nunchi pa ki velli ma daaka raavatam but we cannot use this because in Sankarabharnam we use that gamakam. All gamakams though we can give, we don't use. Based on the ragam only we use in Mayamala Gola. But we don't use this gamakam. Okay. So, we know that Rishabham has gamakam, that is small oscillative gamakam from the previous note to the actual note. Previous note is Shadyamam, actual note is Re. Like that, Da also, previous note is Pa and actual note is Da. And Re to Ga is in ascending, it is Yagajaru, upslide. And Da to Ni, upslide. And Sa Ni, Ni to Da, downslide. And Ga to Re, downslide. There is no gamakam, oscillative gamakam for re and da in descending. Most of the times it won't be there. Please, these are all ground rules to make you prepare. It is not the final, but it will give you a clear understanding of all these movements. Okay? So if you want to play anything in any Sarleswaram, like sa re ga ma pa ma ga re. So when you playing second speed and third speed, the gamakam oscillations will be less. So sometimes you play gamani mama anata kuda practice chestam anamata sa re ga ma pa da ni sa pa da sa re sa. So like that higher octaves kuda you can practice like that. This is the half finger, right? In second stage. See, mapa dapa, when I play mapa dapa, because da is not followed by ni, it is followed by pa, then it is considered as descending, then I am not giving gamakam. So then I am not giving mapa da ni. Generally, I am giving gamakam to da. So try to understand this. So like that, you can practice all fundamentals. There is no gamakam or oscillations in janta. Okay, so if you practice, so there are many queries I'll answer. So in third speed there is no proper movement like this. Sorry mama, it sounds like that, very very subtle movement. So people try to play, it sounds like that. If you play sa re ma ma pa sa pa da sa 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 da ba ma ma re sa, then it sounds like that. You have to try, experiment, then you will get that speed. Okay, and the next important thing is that we have learnt maya mala gola, right? Sir, what about the ragams that that coming janya ragas of maya mala gola? So let us take an example of Malahari ragam. Malahari raga, if you take the murchana, is I told you, if you wanted to play any ragam, if I give Malahari ragam, then you immediately ask that what is the janaka ragam of Malahari ragam. Janaka ragam of Malahari ragam is maya malagola ragam. You know maya malagola ragam notes, but then you next you have to ask what is the murchana of Malahari ragam. Sa re ma pa da sa, sa da pa ma ga re sa. So while in ascending sa re ma pa da sa, while descending sa da pa ma ga re sa. Ascending there is no ga and ni, descending there is no ni. So then how to give gamakam? Okay, now you see sa re till here like maya mala gola only, but you cannot go from re to ga with ga finger because there is no ga in ascending. Okay, but still you can go because sari gari is the gari is allowed in this ragam, but I'm telling in murthana sa re go to directly to ma sa re ma, there is no ga sa re ma pa da, again there is no ni, direct go to sa. Okay, next there is no ni, sa to da only, sa sa to this finger I am keeping between ni and sa da sa da pa ma ga re sa is like maya mala gola ma ga re sa sa re ma pa ta sa sa da pa ma ga re sa. So slides are there, upside down slides, and oscillation is only re and da. And because while coming there is ma ga re sa, ga sa re ga re sa is also there, because re gamakam to ga and ga to re, because gari is allowed, then ma ga re sa is also possible. So sometimes you may get a little confusion, but don't think of that deep. Just to follow whatever ragams, if you take Saveri,
Sa Re Ma Pa Da Sa, Sa Ni Da Pa Ma Ga Ri Sa. Sa Re Ma Pa Da Sa, Sa Ni Da Pa Ma Ga Ri Sa.
So the difference between Saveri and Malahari is ascending, Arohana is same, descending, there is Ni in Saveri. But when you wanted to play Saveri Ragam, there is Gamakam for Ma, the sound are different, everything will be different. So trying to understand that Ragam and all, it requires a lot of effort. You have to take proper classes to learn for 3-4 years, then only you will get that Ragabhavam. Otherwise, to play general songs and all, this much information is sufficient. It sounds like that Saveri, but in as per our understanding, like that. Any if you take what is it? Ray Gupti. So if any ragam that is a janya of Mayamala Gaura ragam, and try to understand the Murchana, and as per that Murchana, you try to figure out the Gamakam, whether the Gamakam from Re to Sa to Re and slide from Re to Ga or Ma. So only one thing I wanted to explain you again close this session. One is, see, there is another way of Gamakam, like Sa Re Ga. I told you that in ascending, because Re is followed by Ga, then Re will get Gamakam, that is from Chadyamam to Rishabam in Maya Mala Gola and the related ragams. Sa Re Ga, right? This is ascending. But at the same time, Ga Re Ga or Ma Re Ga is also ascending because Re is followed by Ga or Ma. But the previous notes for Re are not Sa because either Ga or Ma. So then you need to play like this. Ga Re Ga. Ma Re Ga. The previous one is Ma to Re and slide and Ma. Ga to Re and slide and Ga. And Sa Re Ga. One possibility is. And Ga Re Ga. So Riga or Rima or Ripa or whatever it is. The Re is followed by a higher note is called as ascending. So in ascending, one is that ascending and descending. Ascending, ascending ante Sa Re Ga. Descending, ascending ante Ga Re Ga. Gariga, in Gariga Prayogam or Mariga Prayogam or Marima Prayogam, Re will get Gamakam because Re is followed by a higher note. That is called descending, ascending order. Sariga is ascending and ascending order. So please keep that like that. By Devatam also.
Satani Patani.
So like that, you can understand this. Already 40 minutes over. I have work to leave, but I try to just, sir, can you explain the logic for why there is no Gamakam between Ma and Pa in this ragam? I told you that there is a possibility of for Madhyamam Gamakam, but we don't use because we use in certain ragams that I have explained. So, sir, can you please explain how to get the effect in third speed? That also I explained. In sometimes see that this is moved from Pa to Sa in descending. So, do we give Gamakam and start Tarasthai Sa from Pa, sir? Yeah, you can just. It is not Gamakam, just a slide. Pa to Sa.
Pa Sa Sa Pa.
This finger just Sa to Pa. It can be to any note. Okay? Speed Ga Undali, sir, slide movement. That depends on your say.
Sa Re Ga. Sa Re Ga.
Is it sounding better than the previous one? I felt that previous one is good. Otherwise, if I am following some video, whatever the speed they use, that only we use. Sir, I am having difficulty with the gamaka between dentaswarams and slides between consecutive notes. Can you please show how to do it in a bit slow? One thing, I told you dentaswaram, there is no gamakam, just play janta effect. But moving between notes, try practicing. Kari, 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 maga, maga, maga. Diga, 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 ka, ma, ma, pa, pa, ma. Very important. Like that only you play in second speed, you know, the finger positions and everything. You have to work. So if you don't work and ask the same doubts, so I don't have any problem in explaining you all 100 times, but you don't develop. So if you don't develop and play, then what is the fun in doing all these activities? So, and dear sir, have a doubt regarding Sadharana Gandharam and Kaisika Nishadham fingering. Are these two notes right immediately after the Chatushtha Rishabham and Chatushtha Devatam? Correct. So I have already explained, this is Chatushtha Rishabham and this is Sadharana Gandharam. This is Chatushtha Devatam, this is Kaisika Nishadham. But in general charts, there is a some distance, but in Carnatic music, we keep these together because we follow just intonation scale. Okay? Yeah, this is Kaisika Nishadham, Sadharana Gandharam. Okay? Next, can you please show single bow and double bow and their usage according to the speed? So all these are practices. If you play second speed, you use two swaras, or even you can use four swaras in single bow in second speed also. All these are practices. So this is for today. I hope you all got some information. This is very, 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 very important and unique information, I'm telling you. If you find anyone explaining this, please let me know. I don't have any problem. I'm just telling you that it is very important to understand this Maya Mala Gola, Sankaravarnam, and Karahara Priya, Kalyani, Todi, all these five ragams. I'll tell all these five ragams. I will take each ragam in 1 week and try to explain like this, and how to handle the janya ragas, ante child ragas of that particular janaka ragam, particular ragam. So that's why I explained today how to understand the gamakas of Maya Mala Gola ragam and how to understand the gamakas for the janya ragas of Maya Mala Gola ragam based on the murchana and descending and ascending order, where to get oscillative gamakam between the notes, where to get vibrato, how to give a vibrato, where to give ascending slide and descending slide, okay, upside or down slide. So unknown gamakam, just it is like they are called as puritam in jantaswaram, that I will explain in another class. Hope you all got information. If you have any doubts, please post there in the comments or somewhere. I will try to address, or in the next class also I will explain. So like Sankaravarnam, Karahara Priya, Kalyani, and also Todi, I will try to explain the gamakams. So you have to spend it from this week to next week, at least if you can spend 20-30 hours, then you can find some difference. We have been practicing for 20, 25 years, 30 years, and we have been working on this subject. That's why we are able to play. If you wanted to play, if you say like, why am I not getting that much easily how you are playing, means it will not, because pinda koddi roti, enta kashtapadite, how much hard work you put in within right direction. In right direction, that much only you can improve. Okay? Thank you very much. So we will end the live here today. So please stay tuned for the updates, and I may change the time because of my work schedules. Please try to be there. Today also many people try to join on time. So yeah,
Thank you very much. Practice all fundamentals, then try to play other compositions. Thank you very much. Namaskaram. It is like